Well, you've emailed and you've called with one big question over the past couple of months. Where's Sue? A medical crisis has kept her away from this anchor desk since late October. And the good news is that she is well enough to return after the holidays and well enough to finally let us pay her a visit. Neither you or I have seen Sue in I think over 6 weeks right now. And the main risk is the attack dogs coming to visit her. So let's see what happens. Lena and Sophia.
The girls are ready to see you, Charles.
Sue.
Oh, my
yes.
darling, my
Lena
darling.
Lena and Sophia, Pate. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. It's nice to see you. It's been so long.
You look fabulous. Great.
I can swing my arms and walk.
Yeah. Now, I know this whole thing was a ruse just to get NBC makeup and hair over here.
That's yeah. Give it my face back. You should have been here first thing this morning.
Yeah, no, thanks. No, I'm fine. I'd like you after makeup.
Do you? Okay.
Yeah, but I'll take it anyway. It's really good to see you. You gave us all quite a scare.
Well, you know, it was fairly serious. You know, serious enough that when I come back January 3rd, it will have been 8 weeks. And it was very tough on people at work missing me.
Well, it was tough on us. I mean, they're bored to tears with me in the studio. You know, I mean, the entertainment is gone in there.
See. Because the truth of the story is that the fun and games happen when the camera's not on us.
It is true. The guard dog is here taking her.
Yes. This is Sophia Loren Simmons. And she's not going to move, so we might as well just get used to her sitting here.
Well, she has great camera presence. Whenever anybody asks about you, and they ask about you all the time, the first thing they say is, what happened to Sue? And the second thing is, how is she? So let's start with the second thing first. How are you?
Well, I'm good. I really am.
What happened?
Well, I was having trouble walking. We thought it was a hand injury. And then I took an MRI and they called me in. They said, you come to the hospital with your overnight bag. The MRI indicated that there was something in the spine and they couldn't tell whether it was just fluid or a tumor. And so that was why the immediacy of it, because if I'd waited another two or three weeks, that'd have been a real problem.
What did they find?
They found just fluid. There was no tumor. They fixed the 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And they had to break a couple of bones to get in there.
Want to show us your scar?
Okay. Okay. I slowly turn around. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty neat.
It is. They did a very good job.
And who's looking at the back of my neck anyway?
Well, you never give anybody a chance. Not in the studio anyway.
No,
you don't turn your back on anyone.
No. Things could happen.
Yes. Have you missed us?
Yes, I have, and I've watched every pitiful night. No.
And pitiful they've been without you. Good heavens.
No, I watch. Actually, our boss asked me to keep an eye on us, you know.
Yeah.
People think you can't find anything to do at home. Oh, yes, you can.
We haven't been apart for this length of time professionally, since we started.
Right.
Over 30 years ago.
Right.
This has been almost 2 months now.
As you watch each newscast, you're acutely aware that you're not there.
Well, I know the studio crew is really keen to have you back, and the news.
Well, they want to talk baseball, and they want to talk basketball.
They do.
That's the best times we have when we're not on the air, in commercial breaks and tapes, we all have great times.
Yeah, I suspect somebody's taping that. There's a huge blackmail reel somewhere.
Well, you know what? I think they have enough of me on TV to.
Hey, you got a good point.
There's
yes,
no blackmailing
yes,
I
kind of forgotten one or two of those episodes on television.
Yeah. So I have no fear.
What's the message you might have for the viewers who've been calling us and wondering and emailing us, wondering where you are and when you're going to be back?
Well, the message is that I will be back Monday, January 3rd, right after the New Year's, and I'm feeling pretty strong, and I was glad to have the time to recover. I thank NBC for that, for not putting pressure on me to get back to work. You know, so it's been good that way.
And many of you left messages for Sue on NBC New York's Facebook page. Madeline J. Hobgood writes, love and miss you. Hope to see you back soon at the desk. And Adif A. Coleman says, I'm looking forward to having you back at The Rock. And Carmen Bassano left this message. Miss you. Hurry back. Happy holidays and God bless. So how'd she look to you, Janice?
She looks fantastic. You know, we've had some conversations and texting back and forth since she's been away. But just last week, she was on the phone with us in the makeup room, and she was laughing, and she was almost back to her old self. And I see why. She looks fantastic.
Well, she does. And the fact that she let us in. Because she wouldn't let us in.
She's got guard dogs, too. How could you get past those two?
It was tough. But I braved it.
Yes, you did. I'm glad you did that, Chuck. That was
was
really nice. That's really nice. We can't wait to see you, Sue. And happy holidays. Can't wait to have you back.